Okay, so now if you know about the HCF of two numbers and LCM of the same two numbers, is there anything new that comes out of it? Well, yes, there is. The thing is that the product of two numbers, okay, is equal to the HCF, highest common factor, times the LCM, which is basically the lowest common multiple. Okay, so let us see if that is actually true. True or not, okay, we are going to be doing little proof over here. Let's see, I'm going to do the LCM over here, the HCF right beside it, and the product of two numbers over here. Let's say we have two numbers, okay. We're going to use the same two numbers. We're going to use 10 and 15. Now the product of two numbers is going to be over here, which is going to be done over here. Now what is 10 times 15 equals? 150. And what is basically the LCM of 10 and 15? We're going to do that over here. And right beside it simultaneously, we'll be doing the HCF over here. Let's see. Okay, so let's start. 2 times, now wait, 5. I'm going to go with 5. 5 times 2 is equal to 10, 5 times 3 is equal to 15. Okay, because this is the LCM, we're not going to leave 2 and 3 as they are. We are going to reduce them as much as possible. Okay, so 2 times 1 is equal to 2. We're going to leave 3 as it is. We're going to move forward, leave 1 as it is. 3 times 1 is equal to 3, 5 times, okay, well now we're done. This is like 5 times 2 times 3 is equal to 5 2 is times 5 times 2 is equal to 10. 10 times 3 is equal to what? 10 times 2 is equal to 30. Okay, so moving on to the HCF, the highest common factor, 5 times 2 is equal to 10, 5 times 3 is equal to 15, and because we are doing the highest common factor over here, we're going to leave 2 and 3 as they are, and we're going to say that 5 is the HCF. And what is 30? The LCM, lowest common multiple. Okay, so let us see if this is actually true. What are we going to do? I'm going to do it over here. The product of the two numbers is 150, and our HCF, highest common factor, times our lowest common multiple are going to be over here, and we're going to see if the both of them are going to be equal or not. The highest common factor was 5. We have 5, and then our LCM, 30. Now, let's see. 5 times 0 is equal to 0, 5 times 3 is equal to 15. Oh yes, they are actually equal. So if you have the HCF of the exact same two numbers and the LCM of the exact same numbers, you can actually find the product of those two numbers. This is actually pretty useful because with the questions which actually come in the exams are something like this. Okay, so say we have two numbers and the product of, this is the first and basically the last question we're going to do. The product of two numbers, okay, the product of two numbers is equal to 375. Now, this is not the complete question. We are also given the HCF, and the HCF is equal to 5. Now, the question that they're going to ask is, what is the LCM? What is the LCM? Now, because we know that the product of two numbers is equal to the HCF times the LCM, we're going to do exactly that. 375, which is the product of two numbers, is equal to the HCF times the LCM. And we are going to find what exactly is the LCM of the two numbers. Okay, so just have to do this. And this is equal to what? Let us see. 5 times 5 is 25, 6, 7, 7. 7 and 5 is our 35. 5, 6, 7, 2 down, 5 here, 5 times 5 is equal to 25, and we are done. So miraculously we have the LCM over here, 75, and that is the LCM.